Folks, we're actually going to start at about 7:05, so just a few more minutes. Thank you. Folks, if you'd like to come up and light your candles, there's a lit candle on the corner of each side of the plaza, and there's two on the table also. If you don't have a candle, there's plenty more on the table for you. Good evening, and welcome to the 9th anniversary of the attacks of 9/11 on the United States. The day has come to be known as Patriots Day, and we gather to remember those lost and how our lives have changed in those 9 years since that event. My name is Rob Don, and for those of you who don't know, I'm the Chief of the Metuchen Fire Department, and I'm very, very thankful for everyone who's turned out tonight. I think it's very important that we remember events that affect our lives the way the attacks did on 9/11. One of the things that bothers me is every December 7th, I look around and very few people remember the attack on Pearl Harbor. And while you're not supposed to dwell on things for the rest of your life, there are things or benchmarks in our lives that we cannot forget. So joining together like this is very important. Freedom Plaza was an effort made by the YMCA and the residents of Metuchen and the borough government to commemorate the event. And it was placed here because of the commuter station and the number of people that go through here that work in New York and the number of people that were affected by the events on that day. So again, thanks to the YMCA for their efforts and everyone who helped in the fundraising to create this plaza. And a big thanks to the Chamber of Commerce. They continue year after year, event after event, to promote and sustain our community with their hard work and dedication. The fairs, the parades, this event, so many things are orchestrated and managed by the Chamber and Carolyn Woodruff of the Chamber, that I'd like to thank them also for their efforts. And now I'd like to turn the mic over to David Glassover, President of the Metuchen Chamber of Commerce.
Good evening, everyone, and on behalf of the Chamber and its Board of Directors, I want to thank you all for coming out here tonight. It's nice to see such a nice crowd here on a Saturday evening. And I think it's so important, as Rob said, that we come here every year, we gather here for a few moments to remember and think about the names of everybody on these walls and the others that lost their lives on that day. But even beyond that, I think it's more important that we express our grief, our humanity, and we do what we can do to keep this memory alive, because we cannot forget it, because we must remain vigilant, we must care for each other, we must look out for each other. And I think I think one of the most best examples of that is the near bombing that we had in Times Square earlier this year that was thwarted because people were vigilant. Somebody saw something, somebody said something. So thank you all for coming. Please don't forget this day and keep it in your hearts. Remember those who are no longer here and remember to remain vigilant. Thanks very much.
Reverend Mark McCreary of the Second Baptist Church will give our invocation.
Good evening, everyone. If you would, for me, just along with me, just glance to your left and to your right as your own connection of affirmation to the person sitting on, standing on your right or to your left, just as a note of acknowledgement and affirmation of their presence here, affirming the same emotions and the ideals and thoughts and memories that you have, and as a reflection of solidarity together and our unity in what we're here for this evening. And with that, let's just bow our heads and let's ask the Lord's blessing for this evening and for our lives as we reflect tonight. Let's pray. Father, what a wonderful evening we have tonight, and we give you the glory and the praise for this wonderful evening. We thank you that we're able to gather in this place, gather with our hearts and our minds together, just acknowledging that as we reflect on the events of this day 9 years ago, that our hearts are still sensitive and our minds are still a bit confused. And as we bow, we thank you for this day, and we just pray for the families, all the families who have been directly affected by these events. We just pray their comfort. We just pray their encouragement. just for their lives, so that they can continue day by day and step by step to live out their lives in the full spirit of those who we lost on that day. Then, Father, we thank you that even as we stand here, very sensitive, we thank you that the dust is clearing. And as the dust continues to clear, we just pray your help to teach us what we ought to remember, and show us what we ought to forget, and help us to move forward. Restore our minds and restore our souls, our wills, and our emotions. We need you each and every day. Then we just pray for wisdom as to how to move forward, especially for those who are in positions to make decisions as to how to relate to these issues. We just give you the glory and the praise. And then we just thank you for all who are gathered here in Metuchen. And we pray your blessings on us as residents of Metuchen, as we live together, and as we feel together, and as we remember together. And for it, we'll be careful to give you the glory and the praise. It's in Jesus' name that we pray and we thank you. Amen.
Mayor Thomas Vahala.
Good evening and welcome to all of you. Today, as we gather, we remember the losses suffered by our nation on that eventful day. 9 years ago, our nation faced an unprecedented attack. We acknowledge the losses of our friends, relatives, and loved ones, and still grieve their deaths. All of us were touched personally, and our world changed forever. Today, we also must remember the first responders who gave their lives responding to their final call that day 9 years ago. They remain the true heroes. As a nation, we must never forget, and we must always remain vigilant against future threats. But let us not be swayed or divided by some people who would only divide us and lead us down a path, creating division rather than uniting us and keeping us strong. Let us acknowledge today and remember with each day that we are strongest when we are united. I hope that our nation for generations to come will set aside time on this day every year to create a dedicated moment to remember those lost, and as we remember, to remain vigilant against those who seek us harm. In closing, I ask you for a moment of silence, of silent prayer, for all of our men and women serving in our armed services, protecting our freedoms today. Thank you, and may God bless you and bless our great nation.
Next, Donald Clawson of the Reformed Church will sing God Bless America.
God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans white with foam, God bless America, my home sweet home. God bless America, my home, sweet home. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans white with foam, God bless America, my home, sweet home.
Captain Rob Rettenberg from Metuchen Police Department.
Good evening. For all Americans, for all time, the phrase 9/11 will evoke a special meaning, a memory of a moment in our history when the world as we knew it changed forever. It was a day that we realized that we too were not immune from the horrors of terrorism. It was a day that for the first time in our lives, the feeling of being safe and secure in this great country was a thing of the past. It was a day where fear and uncertainty consumed us. It was a day when cell phones stopped working. It was a day when planes stopped flying. It was a day when we lost three of our own from Metuchen: Cynthia Connolly, Eustace Backus, and Tariq Amanula. It was a day when 343 firefighters, 60 police officers, and 8 paramedics reported to work for their last time. It was a day when 2,997 innocent people died senselessly. It was a day when our country went to war. And it was a day when patriotism was reborn. So today, as we think back on the events of September 11th, it is important to not only remember those who we lost, but to pay tribute to those who are first line of defense against terrorism in America: our federal, state, county, municipal law enforcement officers, as well as our firefighters and EMS personnel. And last but not least, we cannot forget the brave men and women of our military who are serving abroad, risking their lives every day for our freedom and security. Thank you.
Chief of Operations Warren Brooks, Metuchen EMS.
Welcome. Tonight we gather here to remember that it's 9 years have passed since the terrorist attacks against the United States and our way of life on September 11, 2001. That day, Metuchen EMS, including myself, responded to Jersey City to assist in the rescue and treatment of victims from the terrorist attacks against the Trade Center. The fact is, there weren't many patients to treat. The end of our day would be spent moving body bags from boats from people who came over from New York City. What we saw that day would leave an indelible mark in our memories. Fortunately, however, our Metuchen EMS members would come home to their loved ones late that night. Not so fortunate with 411 emergency service workers, including 5 paramedics and 5 emergency medical technicians from my EMS community, who would not come home. We gathered this evening to remember those who lost their lives. They were our families, our neighbors, our loved ones. We also pay tribute to those who gave so much and so selflessly that day: the firefighters, the police officers, the emergency medical workers, and also many civilians who would help injured and disabled co-workers down countless flights of darkened steps that day. Perhaps most importantly, however, I'd like to take a moment and recognize you and your presence here tonight and the sense of community that is Metuchen, because it is your presence that serves as proof, substantive proof, that the 19 hijackers failed abjectly in their endeavor that day to take away our freedoms and our quality of life that we hold so dear. God bless Metuchen, God bless America, and never forget September 11th, 2001. Thank you.
At 8:45 a.m., American Airlines Flight 11 out of Boston has crashed into the North Tower of the Trade Centers. 8:47 a.m., FDNY Manhattan Box 558087 is transmitted for the first alarm. At 9:03, United States Airlines Flight 175 out of Boston is crashed into the South Tower of the World Trade Center. At 9:43, American Airlines Flight 77 is crashed into the Pentagon. At 10:05, the South Tower of the World Trade Center collapses. At 10:10, United Airlines Flight 93 crashes into the fields of Shanksville, Somerset County, Pennsylvania, when the brave passengers of that plane decided they would not be a tool of destruction, and they did not allow that plane to make its target. And at 10:28, the North Tower of the Trade Center collapsed. As firefighters, we share a bond with each other, as do all first responders. But the thing that New York City firefighters, Metuchen firefighters, Edison firefighters, or a firefighter from a company in Alabama that has one engine protecting, you know, 50 square miles with, you know, 500 people in it, all have in common is that when the alarm goes in, they weren't there. They didn't start the fire. It's not their house. They were on the other side of town. Volunteers were home with their families. Paid firefighters were coming on duty, going off duty, and they dropped whatever they were doing to go and answer the alarm. And all across America, every day, first responders do this. They're not part of the problem, we're part of the solution. And that is why we share this bond. The 343 firefighters that perished that day, many of them double crews on apparatus that the last night shift had just ended. When the alarm came in the morning, those guys didn't go home. They geared up, and a truck that should have had six guys on it had 11, had 10. Entire companies were killed. I don't know what to say about that. To lose, you know, 343 in one shot of the almost 3,000 that were firefighters that were not there when the first plane crashed. It's just, that's why we feel such a strong bond to these firefighters. We attended their funerals after. We responded that day to try to help in whatever way we could. And for that reason, again, I also thank you for coming out to recognize the efforts of the first responders and to remember the people that committed no crime that day other than they woke up, they took a shower, they ate their breakfast, and they kissed their family members goodbye, and they went to work, and they never came home again. So whether they pushed a mop, pushed a pen, or drove a fire truck, we all share that same thing, that they were stolen from us, and thank you very much for coming out tonight. Moment of silence, if you'd all please. Now, Metuchen High School junior Christy Timms will sing America the Beautiful.
Waves of gray, for purple.
Another beautiful song. If Pastor Greg McFerrin and Touching Assembly of God, please come up, give our some remarks and benediction.
It's good to be with you this evening. This day has been a day filled with a lot of emotions for all of us as citizens of this community. But we remember here tonight and we reflect upon everything that has been said. And we think about those that sought our harm on that eventful day. They sought to inflict terror in our hearts. But I want to remind you as you look around here this evening, and just take a moment to look around at those that are standing behind you and all around, that we stand here tonight a community. And there is something unique in that word, community, two elements, common unity. They sought to try to take that away, and here we stand 9 years later, and we have a common unity. We need to understand that we need to build for a brighter future. Yes, some of the wounds have closed 9 years to this day. Some remain open. But every wound that heals, there remains a scar. We need to learn from the day and all that took place and hold true to our values as a community, to hold our brothers and our sisters, our neighbors, those around us as dear and special in our hearts, and thank the brave men and women that continue to serve our servicemen and women and those that hold vigil and watch over us. We want to ask a blessing not only upon those that lost, but for those that continue to serve and those who are selfless in their dedication to continue to secure our hope, our freedom, and our future. Would you take a moment to bow with me this evening and pray for those here this night? Our gracious and our loving Heavenly Father, we thank you that you are present and near to us. Father, we pray that you would continue to mend the broken hearts, that you will continue, Lord, to liberate those that are bound. God, we pray that you'll continue to minister your gracious touch, Lord, upon those that are hurting. As we reflect, Father, we pray that you will continue to strengthen the families of those that continue to feel loss. Lord, we pray your blessing, strength, and vigilance upon those that continue to serve this great community and the surrounding communities of our nation. We think, O God, of our brave servicemen and women, Lord, that continue to fight for freedom. We pray, God, that you would keep them and watch over them and protect them. And God, as we go from here tonight, may you continue to help us to stand together, Lord, with common unity, holding these values and holding these truths and holding the memories, Lord, of all of these names that we honor here tonight as valuable and precious in your sight. For we ask these things in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.
Next year will be 10 years. We will gather again and hold another event. We'll talk about those that we lost and the things that have changed our lives. And I hope that in the 365 days from now until then, you will take with you each day as a blessing, and that when you walk out that door, you never know what's gonna happen. So if we live every day to the best, I think we'd all be better for it. I'm not Catholic, but I've attended a lot of Catholic funerals, some weddings, and other events. But one of the things that they do that I always enjoyed was when they the priest asked everyone to turn to each other and say, "Peace be with you." So from one non-Catholic to everybody here, let's do a little "Peace be with you." Folks, if you want to put your candles, we have a can over here for you to put your candles in. So you know, if you want to take them home, that's fine, but blow them out and throw them in.
Get a copy of the program from Carolyn.